Hello friends, welcome to this lecture on single search to library resources, federated search and web scale discovery services. I am Dr. Ramesh Gaur, working as a director library information head Kalanidhi division, Indira Gandhi National Center for the Arts. In this particular lecture, I am going to speak about various kind of discovery services and also how important is searching the web. We know nowadays Google is a very popular tool. Everybody is so fond of Google. When you ask any student or any common man where you search, everybody say that I search on Google. But do you know, they are not aware that Google provide only 15% access to the entire web content. Rest 85% of the web content, which is not indexed by the Google, and that is called deep web or invisible web or hidden web. Basically, this is the part of the worldwide web whose contents are not indexed by any search engines. Forget about Google. It is also known as surface web. And this deep web, if you go further, has also been referred dark web or invisible web. You see the size of that. It is a data of 2000, where the size of surface web was 19 terabyte and the size of deep web was 7500 terabyte, means it that time it was 400 times larger than that. But if you see right now, that size is increasing, and what all contents on deep web resources: dynamic web pages, online contents, private web, limited access web, scripted pages, and many non-HTML contents. If you currently see the size, that size has grown, and many people believe that at least more than 200,000 deep websites are currently exist. And if you see the size of this deep web currently, it is near about 1000 to 2000 times greater than the surface web. So it is so huge, and many times we are missing the access to these kind of contents. And as per an statistics, 90% of the deep web is publicly accessible, means free of subscription. So you can imagine how important is this deep web. Now there are various ways to access this deep web, how to search on this deep web. There are different kind of federated search system, Google servicing also help it. But the most important thing is meta search or discovery. When we talk about federated search, it is a real time search when through single query you are reaching out various webs and getting the result retrieved and being shown to you in a certain kind of relevancy ranking system. Now currently this because of Google, this web scale discovery services has emerged, because people are very happy with the Google. So people thought of that, let's design something for libraries which is similar to Google. And why this has been thought of, why it has been decided to have this kind of systems? Now we have too much of information on internet. You make a search and you get millions of references. So there are two kind of point of view of searcher. A researcher feel, I don't want to search, I just want to find. Another say, just give me the answer and make sure it is right. Researcher has always been looking for information which is most relevant and most appropriate to them, And how to get that kind of most appropriate information? It is becoming an impossible task for a common researcher. If you see this study related to changing research behavior of users, which was conducted by the various kind of agencies, and this report is also available on this. It has clearly giving certain kind of indication of the user behavior in recent past. It also help in understanding like present day researcher what kind of challenges he or she is facing and what exactly they want. They want simplified systems. They do not want 72 databases, 72 links. They do not want a separate catalog. They do not want a separate institutional repository. They want just like Google, everything is being easy and very fast and being updated regularly. So, they can search just like Google. And keeping that in mind, libraries have been evolving over the period. If you go into the past, libraries started with this catalog register, moved to the catalog cards, and then this old system of online catalog, then we moved to various integrated library management softwares, and now we are having BaboPack online catalog, and slowly we are moving in a different other advancement in terms of library catalog. So, if library catalogs are emerged now in an integrated manner, similarly with the invent of electronic resources or e-revolution, we have 90% of journals are available online, there are so many databases, thesis repository, institutional repository. So, how to cope up with this kind of scenario? And to face these kind of challenges, these kind of search system have been developed. And let us talk about the federated search first. See a library scenario, where library is subscribing different kind of databases. In this federated search, there are both open source as well as commercial softwares are available, where user is being given facility to search all the databases and catalog in a single time search mode using a single query. But this is a real time query and response is being accumulated and being merged, virtually merged and arranged in a based on relevancy ranking. But there are certain kind of problem in federated search. The first is that it is directly depend on the servers being accessed different locations. It also depend upon the indexing system of that particular database or service. So, to overcome certain kind of issues, a new concept in form of discovery service emerged. In this system, a pre-index metadata is being generated. There is a single entry point, same as in case of federated search. But here the data is not being searched live. A meta search is being created and that meta search is being provided to the user to get it access. How it works? Like in federated search, a query was directly going to the all databases, but here there is a layer in form of a consolidated index. So, there is a federated search between consolidated index and other databases, but there is a discovery between user and the consolidated index. So, a service provider is generating a meta search and it is being provided in form of consolidated index. And what are the advantages? First thing is that it is very fast, because user is searching only one server and there is no issue of bandwidth or the up down or any kind of issue in network connectivity. Fast absolutely very, very good advantage. Second advantage is here when this meta search is being developed, the professional librarians are creating the pre-index. So, the kind of keywords generated by the librarians are helpful in searching and retrieving the most relevant information. In case of federated search, keywords are depend upon the database provider, but here the professional librarians have been used to develop pre-index metadata, which gives better results. In this BabScale discovery, there is one limitation. There may be certain service provider or certain publishers or database vendor, they may not like to give access for the consolidated index. So, how to deal with that? So, a new solution has been emerged as a combination of federated search and discovery. So, wherever there is no discovery possible, federated search is being linked. So, ultimately you are able to get all the results from all kind of sources and user can get all the data. So, this single search box makes life of the researcher very easier. In this you can search your journals, your newspapers, images, conference proceeding, books, audio, video, magazine, monograph, library catalog, institutional repository, all kind of information can be accessed using this complete discovery services. And now lot of research is being done on this area and lot of Web3 components are being added to this, and in over the new time we may see the more and more beneficial component in this discovery services. So, how this relevancy rank is important? Like when you search on Google, sometimes you see the website which is coming in first is not something you are looking for, because Google give relevancy ranking based on certain commercial interest also, like the website which is sponsoring or paying for it comes first in the search. But here in this case of when the system is designed for the user, seeking the user's convenience, the relevancy ranking will be based on the most appropriate manner, like by giving priority of subject headings, article titles, keywords, keywords within abstract. So, results are much better. This is the example I can give you. This was the service we have implemented in JNU, and how using single window search, all kind of information is being collected and gathered in this single window search. This is another example. Like this is a catalog record, this is an article from journal, this is an e-book. So, all the information, and you have lot of options to refine or use filters. You can use filter year as a filter, publication type as a filter, you can use peer reviewed, you can ask for only full text, you can ask for only thesis article, you can ask for only research articles, you can ask only for books. So, and many times like this also help you in integrating with the open access resources, like this kind of discovery platform can be linked with open access books, open access journal and all kind of open access resources. So, apart from your library resources, you are also getting access to the resources which are not being subscribed by the library. This can be a group of libraries, like a multiple libraries can generate their own discovery platform. It can be various campus can have a single discovery system. So, this is one of the very important and useful application if you want to understand in a more systematic manner. This diagram will help you in understanding how this discovery services are being seen and how it is being implemented. There are a number of commercial web scale discovery services are available. if you see this EBSCO Discovery Services, Summon is there, Primo is there, WorldCat is there. Besides, there is a open access tool, ViewFind. You can use ViewFind also. I am not much familiar with ViewFind, that is why I am talking about all these, because most of these solutions I have used one of other time when we subscribed in JNU, we have a trial access to most of these solutions. Sometimes it is very important to convince the people why we need a discovery services. In India, there is a very strange kind of feelings in the people that they feel that this is something add-on or additional kind of services. We do not mind spending crores of rupees on subscription, but when we have to spend few lakhs on adding such this kind of services, people hesitate. And that is the reason I will say you that if you go worldwide, almost every university in the world are using facilities like remote access or discovery services. So, whenever you implement a new technology, you must see all the options available with you. That is the way I always looked implementing any technology, and we did it in the JNU. We asked for 6 months trial to all kind of options, both federated as well as web scale services. So, there was a two web scale discovery service, EDS and Summon. Then there was two federated search platform, FatGate and Nimbus, and then we asked them to integrate our resources as a pilot, and also a evaluation committee was formed. And after the trial, we collected the usage statistics of each and every resources. We asked the feedback, user feedback, like how users were happy by using all these platforms. And then we also asked the presenters, the vendors, to make the presentation of their resources. A RFP was developed, which gives certain kind of information regarding the product. That RFP was very robust, and then we finally a committee decided on this implementation. Immense usefulness. When you implement a discovery service, this kind of results are visible. This is not something unexpected for me, because why so drastic increase in the usage in 3 years at JNU? Reasons are number of things which I want to explain here. First thing, many times when you are subscribing large number of databases and you have large number of resources, your users are not aware of that. So, when they go through a single search, they able to search certain publication which they do not know, you are already subscribing it. That is the first advantage. Second, sometimes they hesitate in going too many links, they do not have time also. And another important reasons for popularity of this kind of solution is, when you link with remote access, it become very easy for users to search anywhere, anytime. And anywhere, anytime access is very important nowadays, when resource users are very much engaged in various kind of activities and they do not have time to look for various sources. So, single window search, and result is like 3704% increase in 3 years, remarkable. It also helps in certain other things, like it not just usage statistics, but also help the pattern, usage pattern, how when your resources are being downloaded most. So, if you see the largest number of downloads in JNU were sometime in April, because there is examination time, and in November or so why? Because this is the exam time, like students are making most use of the library resources for preparing for the examination. And there is also a time when you see in August, July, August, when the researchers are submitting their thesis. So, this diagram, this chart can help you in understanding your library pattern and usage. You know, even you can generate the usage statistics for each and every resources. So, which resources is being used very, very high, what are the resources which are less used. So, all these things are very important for researchers to understand, and librarians to make a policy and programs to further apart from discovery, if you want to really guide your user about the deep back, there are number of other ways of guiding your researcher. I am giving you the list of various semantic search tools and databases, which are helpful in retrieving deep BAB, means invisible BAB. So, all these listing may not be visible very clearly, but you can download this and can further go on different kind of links. Meta search engines, there are certain kind of meta search engines already available. So, you can make use of these meta search engines in, like, even users can be trained to develop their own meta search engines. There are tools which can help in developing your meta search engines. There are certain kind of general search engine databases. So, it will be very helpful if you guide the users, and this kind of training and awareness to the users, they are exactly not aware what tool they should use to go look for the most authenticated source in their area of interest. So, these academic search engines, there are many subject specific academic search engine for medical professional, for engineering, or all kind of like subjects. If you go, academic search engines are there, scientific search engines are available. This is the tool, number of tools which you can use to design your own search engine to search. There is a lot of collaborative information, number of open access search engines. And to conclude, I want to first thanks all the authors of the resources which I used for the presentation. I have borrowed number of links and resources from various websites. Thanks to all, I acknowledge them. Also thanks my colleagues who have helped me in this presentation. And this is not a presentation which is going to stop you from further using. You can download it and make use of it. I don't have any objection to it. If you have any further query, my email IDs are given. Please feel free to contact me for any specific query, understanding deep web search, and also what is the difference between federated search and discovery search. My recommendation to each and every librarian, these search engines are very important, and this is going to help libraries in creating a new image, because users are struggling on internet. They don't know how to search, what to search, and what is most authenticated source of information. So, in this internet world, librarians can be the best people. I call them knowledge navigators to retrieve most appropriate information for the users. I hope this presentation will be very useful for you. Thank you very much. I hope you like this presentation and may be useful for your activities. For any further clarification, information, please feel free to contact me. My email IDs are given in my presentation. Please email me your further queries. I will be happy to answer you. Thank you.